quote goes like this: a mind that is stretched by new experience can never go back to its old dimensions. A mind that is stretched by new experience can never go back to its old dimensions. Good morning. I would like to share a verse from the scripture, from Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 13. The Lord will make you the head and not the tail. The Lord will make you the head and not the tail. Yes, friends, let's all be assured today that by the grace of God, that we'll always be the head and not the tail. With this assurance, let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, I thank you for this day that you have given us, Lord. Lord, I pray that your presence might fill this whole auditorium, Father. Lord, I commit all the students and staff members seated in this place. Fill us with your presence, Lord, and speak to us. Father, once again, I ask that your grace might lead us throughout this whole day. I commit everything into your mighty hands. Take complete control. Guard us and guide us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Now, let's all join with Sharon and team and sing You Carry Me.
Every moment of my life, God, you never left my side. Hope you enjoyed that video. Yes or no? Yes. This morning, I want to remind you, my dear friends, what God's promised for every one of us. This morning, God said that He's going to make you the head and not the tail. If you receive that promise in your heart, you must know how we are going to become head. All right? So, a few things that we need to take into account is this, that our decisions and choices that we make every day, it's going to make a difference in our lives. It says, I am not a product of my circumstances. I am a product of my decisions. According to this quote, very clearly says that every time and every day we make so many decisions, and that is the sum of the thing that we are today. Yesterday we had taken so many decisions and we are facing the result of it today, or the consequences, or the victory, or the success. The success relies much on the decisions that we make today. And so, my dear friends, please remember, carefully choose the decisions, all right? Each decision is a choice you make about what action to take, okay? Now, I want to tell you this one. When you make a decision, actually, you are taking in charge of your future. How many of you thought about this? When you take a decision, actually, you are taking in charge of your future. I often tell my dear student friends, hey, you need to look into that fourth year, you know, that day when our Honorable Chancellor on stage, all the dignitaries on stage, all our HODs, teachers, and our student friends, our family, friends, everyone. And then you are receiving the certificate for which you are here, for which you are getting trained. Can you think of that glorious day? When you think of that glorious day, the moment you are waiting for 4 years or more than that, you are waiting, toiling, you are working very hard every day. The decisions that you make, the choices you make, inch by inch, you are moving to that glorious day. But my dear friends, that glorious day, if that is to be glorious day, your decisions has to be wise. Your choices has to be wise. You need to set your mind in a very focused way, then only you can achieve that. Let me give you an example from the Bible. There is Daniel, a character in the Bible we see. He was a brilliant chap. Young chap like you, but he was taken as a captive and he was under the slavery. But you know what? He said in his heart, it says, I will not defile myself with royal food and wine. And he asked the chief official for permission not to defile himself this way. All right, the royal food contains so many things that goes against his conscience. So he refused. But you know what? He is going to take not a popular decision at that point of time, many people think. The scripture reads to us saying this way, young men in whom was no blemish, but handsome and skillful in all wisdom and gifted in knowledge and understanding, science, and such as had the ability them to stand in the king's palace, and whom they might teach the learning and the language of the Chaldeans. My dear friends, the opportunity given to Daniel was this, that he is going to made one day to stand in the presence of a king. That's a beautiful job. Who wants to refuse it? Nobody wants to refuse that job. It's a glorious moment. But you know what? He said that I am not going to defile myself, which means that he is going to say no to that position. So to say. In other words, it's not a popular decision at that point of time he is taking. But then he took that decision well in accordance with God's will. It's very clear. And so, later on we read how brilliant he was. He was in fact 10 times better than anyone else who chose to drink and eat king's food. Even this morning, just like Daniel said, I will not defile myself. Can we take a decision today telling that I will never compromise on certain values, on certain things that I have come here for? My dear friends, such kind of decisions and choices that if you make, it's definitely going to be a blessing in your life. And that's what God says to us. God says that I'm going to make you head and not the tail. How many of you want to be the head? How many of you want to be successful? If so, select your choices. Make decisions appropriately. Now, young people like us, we are all thrown into, you know, the world that gives you so many opportunities, or I would say, you know, situations where we have to take decisions either good or bad. Okay? Temptations can come through friends or situations, but you know what? That moment, the decision makes the whole difference. I want you to focus on that glorious day when you receive that beautiful moment, you know, that certificate in your hand, and then move on to that glorious future. God is very much clear on this. Every child who follows this, God will make them head. And that is the testimony of so many people. And so this morning, my dear friends, let's keep Daniel as the role model for all of us. And as Daniel said, let's also take a decision saying that I will never drift away from the desires and from the decisions that I take. I will never be dragged by the temptations of this world, but rather I will be focused. I will take a decision in such a way that I will glorify the Lord's name. Shall we look into the Lord in prayer, asking, God, help me today that I may take a decision. I make wise choices in my heart that will bring glory to the Almighty God. Shall we pray? Father, this morning, we humble and surrender our lives to you, Lord, knowing that, Lord, you are our Creator. And we are so comforted for the fact that we are not confused in any state, but we are under the perfect knowledge of God, and you know every step that we take and every decision that we make. Today, help me, Lord, help us, O God, that we may make a decision in accordance with your will. Father, we pray and bless all the students who are seated here. In their hearts, they may be thinking so many things, things of uncertainty, worries or anxiety. Even this morning, Lord, I commit them into your loving hands. Father, I believe that you are in charge of their life. Father, help them to take a decision that will glorify your holy name. Make the rest of the day as a blessing for all of us, Father, and we give you the glory. We surrender our lives to you. In Jesus' most precious name, we pray. Amen.